At the end of part one, we saw Snoop Dogg with the purple light in his right hand, speaking about defeating Kane and the world becoming one.
I greatly appreciate you guys for coming out tonight. Wonderland right now is in desperate need for us to become one. Everybody know that me and Kane got a thing. I don't like him, he don't like me. I've come to find out that it's about all of us becoming one to unite to fight against that man called Kane.
The mention of Kane is a reference to Cain and Abel and brothers fighting against one another with the added notion of people becoming one or brotherly love, which is connected to the Olympics. Make note of the mention of Cain and Abel, as you'll see it again later. However, the mention of brotherly love connects back to Kobe Bryant, the Black Mamba, who scored 81 points January 22nd, 2006.
Tonight, and an 81-point game. History tonight at Staples Center.
Strong's Concordance lists G81 as Adelphates, which means brotherhood, brotherly kindness, as a reference to the connection of allied nations. Kobe Bryant was from Philadelphia, the city of brotherly love, and he also connected himself with his father's team, the Philadelphia 76ers, as well. Not only that, but when the date of Kobe's death is added together in this fashion, 1 plus 26 plus 20 plus 20, we get 67, which, when reversed, is 76, exactly the same sum of the date of his father's death. 2 years after scoring 81 points, Kobe played for the United States Olympic basketball team. The word athlete comes from Strong's G118, athleo, which means to engage in a contest, to contend in public games, to contend for a prize, as a reference to Olympians. It also means to endure and to suffer. The Apostle Paul compared living a life in this world in service to God with running a race in 1 Corinthians 9, 24-25, which declares, "Know ye not that they which run in a race run all, but one receiveth the prize? So run that ye may obtain. And every man that striveth for the mastery is temperate in all things. Now they do it to obtain a corruptible crown, but we an incorruptible." In synchronizing his endorsement of Kamala Harris with the opening of the Olympics, the Antichrist, Barack Obama, was letting the world know that the games, or tribulation period, in which many will endure suffering, are about to begin. By the way, make note of the mention of synchronicity and timing, as we'll come back to it shortly.
Kamala!
Hello. Hi!
Hey there!
Aw, hi, you're both together. Oh, it's good to hear you both.
I can't have this phone call without saying to my girl Kamala, I am proud of you. This is going to be historic.
We called to say Michelle and I couldn't be prouder to endorse you and to do everything we can to get you through this election and into the Oval Office.
Oh my goodness. Michelle, Barack, this means so much to me. I am looking forward to doing this with the two of you, Doug and I both, and getting out there, being on the road. But most of all, I just want to tell you the words you have spoken and the friendship that you have given over all these years mean more than I can express. So thank you both. It means so much. And we're going to have some fun with this too, aren't we?
The call to Kamala by the Obamas was clearly staged, but they expect you to believe that they just happened to be filming Kamala when she received an unexpected call from Barack and Michelle Obama to endorse her. Notice, Kamala says, "We're going to have some fun."
And we're going to have some fun with this.
This statement, coupled with the fact that her endorsement came at the beginning of the opening ceremonies for the Olympics, is a signal that the games are about to begin. Obama's endorsement of Kamala Harris in conjunction with the opening ceremonies of the Olympic Games as a reference to the opening or beginning of the tribulation period was confirmed by the fact that the 2024 Summer Olympics opened with a depiction of the rider on the white horse, or Antichrist, riding across the river Sin as a reference to Revelation 6:2. This connects back to the white and black horses that ran through the streets of London on April 24th, or 424, as a reference to this ritual being performed for number 44, Barack Obama. The Summer Olympics is a reference to the Sumerian and Babylonian empires and points to the coming one world beast system of Antichrist. Obama's synchronized endorsement of Kamala in conjunction with the opening ceremonies serves to identify Obama as the rider on the white horse, or Antichrist, as found in Revelation 6:2. This is further confirmed by the iron horse that carried the white Olympic flag, because it is called Zeus. We know that Zeus, the god of thunder, is the same as Thor and Baal, who are also associated with thunder or the lightning bolt. We also know that Barack Obama, which means lightning from heaven, connected himself with Zeus at the 2008 DNC, when the stage was set up as a replica of the Temple of Zeus. Not to mention, the 2008 DNC was held at the Denver Broncos Stadium, which has a white horse perched atop the stadium, further connecting Obama with the rider on the white horse.
Profound gratitude and great humility, I accept your nomination for presidency of the United States.